Welcome to John Grosner's New Haven Railroad Derby Junction. Construction on this layout started in 2000 and was completed in 2009. Currently, the layout is 20 feet by 16 feet and it models Derby, Connecticut and also Maybrook. This layout is modeled in the transition era, so you will see New Haven steam and you'll also see New Haven diesels. The track you see is all hand-laid code 70 track, and any hidden track on the layout is code 83. The benchwork is open grid. Some key areas on this layout are North Canal Street, South Canal Street, Derby, Turkey Brook Yard, and also Maybrook. This layout was also featured in the April 2008 issue of Model Railroader. This section of the layout is known as North Canal Street. As we move along the layout, now we're on the back side of South Canal Street. Quite a number of these structures that you see on the layout have all been kitbashed and scratch built. Now, John built these right from photos from Derby, Connecticut. And later on in the presentation, we're going to show you photos of the actual buildings and then also the models that he built. So we're on the front side of Canal Street now, and you're going to see quite a few areas that can be switched out. One of the areas that is really cool to switch out is South Canal Street. There's lots of street running and lots of opportunities to switch, as you can see right in front of you. In addition to the kitbashed and scratch-built structures, you're going to see a lot of craftsman kits, like the one we see in front of you from Fine Scale Miniatures. And I have to say, this is definitely one of my favorites that is on his layout right now. One of the cool things about John's layout is the amount of detail that's on it. The more you look, the more you see. And this is one of the really cool spots I like to see all the time is the area of the Housatonic River. Another cool area of this layout on the Housatonic River is this construction scene. And way back when, there was a construction company that came in and was actually pulling gravel and sand out of the Housatonic River. So John represented that work on his layout. Plus, it serves as a covering for the track that goes underneath it. There's actually a hidden track underneath where trains pass through the layout. So this section of the layout is Derby, Connecticut, and obviously this town has been compressed to fit, and there is a station in the background near the tree line. So we're going to get a closer look at Derby Station in the back. And next to Derby Station is the actual Y. Now the Derby Junction Y is still there as of today. So another little section that we're going to show you, there's a little HO scale figure in the river there, and John's going to point to it right now, and that represents his father who enjoyed fly fishing. So we're seeing the actual control panel for Derby Junction. And as we pan to the right, we're going to see the Naugatuck River Bridge. One of my favorite scenes on this layout is this partially sunken barge. I mean, John did such a magnificent job modeling the flooded barge on a corner there. So now we're approaching Turkey Brook Yard. And I will say, speaking from experience, during op sessions, this could be a very, very busy area. As we round a corner on Turkey Brook Yard, you're going to see a boxcar from the Huntington and Hartford Railroad. We are now in the Maybrook Yard section of the layout, so you're going to see quite a few pieces of rolling stock and locomotives. One detail worth mentioning is the piping from the switch tower is actually accurately modeled on John's layout. And you can see the piping running along the track, under the track, to all the switches. So we're now inside the Maybrook Yard area, and this to the area to the left is the engine facility that's equipped with a turntable, roundhouse, engine house, sanding tower, and water tower. During op sessions, this area is always manned to serve as a dispatcher.
Well, that's rough even. I was gonna put some trap rock colors in here, but
So now we're going to take a look at the prototype photos that John used to model some of the parts of his layout. this particular building has its own sound effects and also its own roll-up door. Looks like somebody's doing some welding. And finally, we have a working car scale. There's an actual gauge underneath mounted on the fascia that shows the car's tonnage. I hope you enjoyed this video of John Grosner's New Haven Railroad Derby Junction layout. As you can tell, it accurately depicts the New Haven back in the transition era. I want to thank John for allowing me to record this video and share it with all of you. Please leave a comment. Thanks for watching, everybody.